Now you have to see, this is the another video which is related to the application of the Gauss theorem, and this is the second application. What we have written, electric field due to a uniformly charged infinite density, means one infinite density is there, and we want to calculate the strength of electric field by using the Gauss theorem, right? So for that, you have to see, suppose here we are making one infinite density. Suppose this is the one point we are going to consider. Suppose this point A is there, and which is r distance from this seat, and where we want to calculate the strength of electric field, right? So symmetrical point A here, and other side of the this infinitely charged density we are also going to consider. Suppose this is what A is, which is also this distance, this is what r distance is, right, from the seat. Now for calculation of the strength of electric field at point A, here we are going to draw the Gaussian surface. Suppose this is the one cylindrical Gaussian surface. This is the cylindrical Gaussian surface which is cutting this infinite density in structure. And surface area density, uniform surface area density, suppose we are going to consider, this is the sigma. Sigma, this is the uniformly surface area density, right? Now here you have to see that the length of this Gaussian surface, total length, this is what 2r is there, right? And here this is the positively charged density is there, so direction of the electric field, this is what this is, means parallel to the axis of this cylinder. Here also in this direction, this is what suppose this is the vector, right? Now after this one, what we want to calculate, we want to calculate the total electric flux linked with this Gaussian surface, right? This is what your Gaussian surface. The Gaussian surface. So let, if phi, this is the total electric flux linked with this Gaussian surface. Here you see three surfaces are there. This is the first one, this is the first end. Suppose this is the first one. Suppose the total surface area of this end, this is S1, and then after this is the curved surface area. So total, suppose this is what S2, and then after this is what, this is what S3. Then total electric flux linked with this Gaussian surface, suppose this is the phi, so this is equal to phi 1, means this is the electric flux linked with this end, and then this is the plus phi 2, means this is the electric flux linked with this curved surface, and then after this is the phi 3, means this is the electric flux linked with this third surface, right? So one by one we are going to calculate phi 1, phi 2, and then after this is the phi 3. So for calculation of phi 1, here you see total surface, this is the what S, and suppose for calculation of the electric flux, suppose here this is the one small segment, small area element is there, this is the ds1, and then area vector, this is what parallel to this electric field. So total electric flux linked with this surface, this is the cyclic integral S, and here this is the vector E dot ds. Here this is the phi 1, this is the cyclic integral over S, vector E dot ds, and here you see angle between vector E and ds1, this is what, 0 degree. So simply we can write, this is the cyclic integral over S, this is the magnitude of vector E, magnitude of ds1, and then after this is the cos 0 degree. At this we can write cyclic integral vector E and ds, E and then after ds, right? E, this is the constant, so we can write E cyclic integral over S this is the ds1. So cyclic integral over a ds1 means simply this is the s1. So here we are writing this is the es1. This we are written. Means the total electric flux linked with this surface, this is the E dot S1. Now after this one you have to see, for the second one, this is the first. Now the electric flux linked with this curved surface area means phi 2, this is equal to cyclic integral over S2. This is the, for this one we are going to consider, suppose this is the small area segment is there and then this is the DS2. This is what a ds2 and area vector here have to see in this direction. This is the vector ds2 and here in this direction this is the electric field is there and they are making what a 90 degree angle because this is the electric field and here this is the direction of the area vector. They are making how much angle? This is the 90 degree for each and every point. So in this case, this is the total electric flux linked with this curved surface area. This is the vector E dot ds2, right? So this is equal to, again same thing is there, cyclic integral over s2. This is the magnitude of vector E, magnitude of ds2, and then after angle this is the cos 90 degree. So cos 90 degree we know that this is what, 0. So the electric flux linked with this curved surface area, this is what, 0. So no need to calculate because cos 90, this is equal to 0. So total term, that is for 0. Now then we want to calculate the electric flux linked with this S3 and here you have to see that S1, this must be what, equal to S3 because these are the both ends of what, right circular cylinder, right? So if phi 3, this is the electric flux linked with this S3, so phi 3, this is equal to cyclic integral over S3, this is equal to vector E dot, suppose here small segment we are going to consider, this is the ds3, so area vector, this is the parallel to the this electric flux, oh sorry, this electric field vector E. So vector E dot ds3, again same thing, this is the cyclic integral over s3, this is equal to magnitude of vector E, magnitude of ds3 and then cos 0 degree, right? So when you are going to calculate, this is the cyclic integral over S3, this is what, magnitude of E means simply this is the E, ds3 and then cos means 1, E you have to take out. So this is the cyclic integral S3, this is the ds3 means this is the simply S3, right? So ES3, so this phi 3 we are calculating. So phi 1 here you have to see, this is ES1. Phi 2 here we are calculated, this is the 0, means no electric flux linked with this curved surface area, then this another end is there, then electric flux phi 3, this is what, ES3. Now total electric flux linked with this Gaussian surface, after this that we are going to rub, suppose this is the 1, here this is the star, this is the 2 and then after this is the 3, right? After that we are going to rub. Now here you see, now total electric flux linked with this Gaussian surface phi from star, total electric flux phi, this is linked with Gaussian surface then from 1, 2 and 3. So phi 1, this is what, EDS1, sorry ES1, and this is the phi 2, this is the 0 and then plus this is the ES3. If so, this we can write, if S1 equal to S3, suppose we are saying that this is the S that we are saying, means S1, this is equal to S3 and what we are saying that this is the S, right? So what we will get, phi, this is the ES plus ES, means this is the 2 times ES, means this is the total electric flux linked with this Gaussian surface. After that we are going to use Gauss theorem. Now, here you see by Gauss theorem, electric flux linked with this closed surface phi. This is equal to Q, means total charge enclosed by this Gaussian surface. Q, this is the total charge enclosed by this Gaussian surface upon epsilon naught. Where Q, this is equal to what? Total charge enclosed by cylindrical surface. Cylindrical Gaussian surface, right? But total charge we want to calculate, because what we know that we know the surface, uniform surface area density, this is the sigma. So by definition of the surface area density sigma, this is equal to what? Q. And then after total area, suppose this is what? A is there, right? Or S is there. Surface area, this is this. So Q equal to, we can write sigma into S. So what we will get? Now this, so phi, this is equal to sigma S upon this is what? Epsilon naught. Suppose this is the fourth, and then after this is the fifth one. Now this is the electric flux and this is also the electric flux. So you have to compare 4 and 5. So from 4 and 5, what we will get? Electric flux means 2 into 2 E into S. This is equal to here, this is the sigma S upon this is what? Epsilon naught. So this is the cancel out. So what we are getting, that 2E, this is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, or we can write E, this is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. It means that electric field, due to the uniformly charged infinitely plane sheet, it is not depends upon the area of the Gaussian surface, simply it depends upon the surface charge density, means E is directly proportional to the surface charge density sigma, right? This is the third application of the Gauss theorem. Electric field due to two infinite parallel sheets of the charges. So for this one, suppose here we are going to consider, suppose this is the one sheet and here this is the another sheet. Both are the what? Positively charged. These are what? Positively charged sheets are there. They are having the support different charge densities, and suppose their separation, this is what R, and suppose this is the seat first and here this is the seat second, and we are going to consider a unit vector which is directed from seat first to seat second, right? Suppose sigma 1, this is the surface charge density of the first one, and sigma 2, this is the uniform surface charge density of the seat second, right? Now here if you see, we want to draw the pattern of the electric field due to both the seats. So this is the positively charged, so electric field, suppose due to the first seat, this is the E1, vector E1, which is also due to the first seat, this is the vector E1, and in this direction this is what? The vector E1. Now due to the second seat, suppose this is the direction of the electric field, means this is the E2, vector E2, this is the vector E2, now here this is the vector E2. Now here to see, we want to calculate the electric field due to the two infinitely parallel planes. It means here if you see, these three regions are there. Suppose this is the first region, this is the second region, and then this is the third region. So here this is the, suppose this is the first region, and here this is the region second, and then after this is the region third. And all three regions we want to calculate the strength of electric field at any point. Suppose this is the region first is there, and here suppose this is the point P. here we want to calculate what is the value of the electric field, and in this region, suppose this is the point Q is there, and here we want to calculate the strength of electric field, and suppose this is the region R, and here we want to calculate the strength of electric field, right? So for region 1, what is the value of total electric field at point P? So if vector EP, this is the total strength of electric field at any point P, then vector EP, this is equal to EP by principle of superposition. This is the vector E1 plus vector, this is the E2. Now here, what is the value of vector E1? You have to see, this is the infinitely plane, seat is there, so that we are calculated here. This is the sigma 1, this is the surface charge density. So sigma 1 upon 2 epsilon naught, right? And then after here, you see, this is the vector we are written, but here now this is scalar, so we want to make the vector. So this is the, this is multiplied by unit vector r cap, but here you see the direction of this E1 and this r cap, both are what, opposite in direction. So this is what here we are writing, this is the minus vector r cap, right? This is, and then after plus E2, you have to see, this is also in this direction, and this is the electric strength of electric field due to the second seat. So here this is the sigma 2 upon 2 epsilon naught, and also same condition is there, this is opposite to this one, so this is the minus R pi. Now you have to take the common. So what is the common? This is the minus R pi upon 2 epsilon naught, this is what, sigma 1 plus sigma 2, right? This is the vector E. So this is the strength of electric field in region first at any point. This is the minus vector R curve 2 epsilon naught sigma 1 plus sigma 2. Now in this region, if you see, for region second, here to see, in the region second, we want to calculate the strength of electric field. Suppose this is in region second, suppose we are going to consider any point, this is the Q. So if vector EQ is the strength of electric field at any point which is lying in second region, so this is equal to, again, vector by principle of superposition, E1 plus, this is what, E2, right? So E1, you could see that this is the direction of E1, and this is the direction of what, unit vector, they are lying what, in same direction. So this is equal to sigma 1, because E1, this is the electric field due to the first seat, and then after 2 epsilon naught, and then after simply this is R cap, right? Because here vector E and vector R cap both are having same direction, so here we are taking this as a plus sign. And plus E2, you have to see that this is the direction of the electric field, and then this is the direction of the unit vector, they are opposite in nature. So here we are writing, this is the sigma 2 upon 2 epsilon naught, this is the minus of R cap. Now you have to take out the common. This is the this is equal to R cap upon 2 epsilon naught. So this is the sigma 1 minus sigma 2. So this is the strength of electric field in the region second. E vector EQ cap, this is the any general point we are taken, this is the R cap 2 epsilon naught sigma 1 minus sigma 2, right? After that, for third point, you have to see, in the second, in the third region, you have to see that if suppose we are going to consider any point which is lying in this region, suppose this is water R. So if vector ER is the strength of electric field at any point R which is lying in third region, so this is equal to vector E1 plus E2, right? Again, you have to see that both are what, in same direction, and here this is the direction of the unit vector, this is also what, same. So this is equal to sigma 1 upon 2 epsilon naught, this is the R curve, positive, because this and this both are what, having same direction, and plus this is the sigma 2 upon 2 epsilon naught, this is the R curve, sigma 2, this is the uniform surface charge density sigma 2 due to the second sheet, and sigma 1 this is the uniform surface charge density due to the first sheet. So something you have to take the common r cap upon 2 epsilon naught. So this is the sigma 1 plus sigma 2. So this is the vector ER. So this is what in third region, and then after this is what in second region, and then this is the what in first region, right?